This next one goes out with both regret and gratitude. Regret to any of you who find it in poor taste, which is to say probably about everybody. And gratitude to Mr. Bum Farley, who in fact is a used car salesman in Dallas, Texas. But under the laws of poetic license, and because I'm the scoundrel that I am, I stole his name and promoted him to a gravedigger. Thank you, Bum, and God bless you. Bum Farley came home when the big war was through. Couldn't hold a job for the holes in his attitude. Normandy scarred him from the inside out, so he loaded his luck in a borrowed truck and headed south from Port Dimitri. Then an ad in the Fort Worth Star one day said, "Call if you like working with clay." He didn't have much good to say when he found himself digging graves, neck high in the Great South Plains caliche. But he learned the trade and he learned it right, and earned a reputation several counties wide. He made that shovel his worst best friend. The ground was hard and the days were hot, so he worked nights when the torrid spring came. Yeah, he buried strangers and he buried friends. He kept his sense of humor through all his loneliness. He never dwelled long on his lonesome blues. He said women come and women go, and I guess he'd know. Sometimes he'd bury three a day. And a working man with a calloused heart ain't no lady's friend. Death kicked beneath his fingernails and no time on his hands. Well, Bum hired a partner named One-Armed Ray, who had one arm just like his name. He wasn't much with a shovel, but he held his scotch and the lantern, and with his one good hand he took home half the pay. It didn't seem to bother Bum in a doggone least that he dug 6 foot and got paid for three. One-Armed Ray was his right-hand man. They'd share a jug and a dirty joke, philosophize till dawn about the deceased. Yeah, they could talk all night about death and birth, about which come last and which come first. Either way, said One-Armed Ray, just our luck, we'd get stuck shucking mud and cussing middle age. They'd bury attorneys in 9 foot of ground and joke they ain't bad guys way deep down. And one time they kissed a priest before laying him to rest, and stole his golden molars and lived like popes for the better part of May. Eating only dust and living just enough to justify their roles. When you're the devil's slave and you're paid by the grave, hell, you never get out of the hole. One night they was burying a Mexican whore. She died of old age at 34. 2 a.m. and the bottle gone. The Bum threw his shovel down, spit in the wind and lit up like a saint. Then he wrestled with her coffin and lifted the lid. The dark concealed her face, and it's a good thing it did. One-Armed Ray stood mouth agape, and in his best Errol Flynn, Bum said, "Me a more? Let's tango this night away." Then Bum hummed a rumba he'd heard overseas and winked one eye, One-Armed Ray. Ray laughed loudly and beat his chest while Bum led her in 3/4 step, tripping over headstones left and right. And when that big June moon slipped behind a cloud and their bellies burned from laughing so loud, Ray pronounced a couple, man and wife. Then Bum squeezed her breast and kissed her lips. put her back in the ground and said goodnight. And now the ladies bleed pure sympathy when Bum talks about his long-lost bride. He just says he married her and buried her all on the same night.